Fairfax ordered their teachers back to school and offered them the opportunity to take unpaid leave or leave the system. Why can't ACPS do this? And you know, first and foremost, I think it's important for us to know that we are an employer of employees, and their well-being is so important. We don't want to develop a hostile environment where we say, you either do what we say or get out, you know? I mean, and that, I'm just trying to be as blunt as the question was asked, because what ends up happening, and I think we're seeing this in school divisions across this country, when you take a stance in that or take a position like that, it's a no-win situation. One, when you have large numbers of staff who say, well, in spite of what you said, I'm not returning at all, you've now put the organization as a whole in a very serious bind, because you don't have the employees, and then they're also disgruntled. This pandemic at some point will be over, I hope, and they are still going to be employees of our school division. And it's our job, I know it's my job for sure, to make sure that I'm keeping their best interests at heart as well. So their voices matter just as much as our families' voices matter. But I don't know if Dr. Wilkins, you wanted to elaborate anything on the, either you come back or you take unpaid leave or you get out of the system.
Thanks, Dr. Hutchings. I would just remind everyone that our approach is to be a more caring and compassionate employer. As I mentioned earlier, over half of our staff have already indicated that they are impacted by that pandemic health situation to such an extent that they are having difficulty being able to come to work, right? And for an employer to simply dismiss the impact of the pandemic health situation on the home life, not just the work life, right? It would be very short-sighted and ill-advised, right? We want to be an employer of choice. And by being an employer of choice, we want to be an employer who understands its workforce, right, and does everything to support its employees for top performance. So from the Alexandria City Public Schools perspective, you're seeing a very deliberate listening and engagement process to understand what exactly is going on with our employees with respect to the pandemic health situation, because we want to keep our employees for the long term, not just through these next few months for the pandemic, but for the long term. And we can do that by listening and supporting our employees in this very challenging and difficult situation. Dr. Hutchings.
Well said, Dr. Wilkins. I just want to reiterate that that whole caring piece is so important. You know, we're an educational institution. I think that should be at the top of our list, to be caring and to be professionals and to understand that our staff members, they have families, they have needs, they have stressors as well. And we want to make sure that we're working with them, not against. And we want to continue to be a caring environment for not only our students, but also for our staff. So the next question, and this is for Dr. Mazingo, why will we be using a hybrid model upon our return? Is it because we are short on staff? If you can foresee a staff shortage, can you begin recruiting extra staff now so that we can return in person 100%. So this is really related to the capacity and us trying to adhere to the social distancing, but Dr. Mazingo, you wanna answer that?
I'm sorry. Yes, certainly, thank you. Thank you so much, Dr. Hutchins. Yes, I would like to answer that from an instructional lens. What I like to kind of restate is that there is an advantage to the hybrid model, and what it does, and it's not as a result of the shortage per se, but it allows us to be able to get groups of children back into the school, as well as staff members back into the school. It allows, as I said earlier, to build those relationships, to create that personalization, to also help us with the reduction of that learning loss. There are many educational reasons for the hybrid model. While we know that there might be some challenges in terms of adjusting, we will be able to the environment and to the new setting and the expectations, we feel like our students will be resilient enough to be able to adjust to the hybrid model, but it does have a lot of educational value for just getting students back into the schools over at least 2 days a week. That's what I see as a paramount value for the hybrid model.
Looking at our teachers of our 1,290 classroom teachers, 691, or approximately 55%, said they would be able to return. This is the light gray portion that you see in these pie charts. So at the elementary level, 57.5% are able to return. Middle school level, 54.3% are able to return. And at the high school level, 51.2% are able to return.